As a brown Australian and a Tamil born in Chennai, India, where Kamala Harris's mum was from, I was horrified to see the racist cartoon suggesting racist tokenism published in The Australian. It was even more disappointing to see the editor-in-chief defending it. On the surface level, it might seem like the lack of diversity in the Australian mainstream media is a problem, but isn't it more deep-rooted and complex than just that?
So we're just looking at that image now. I'm interested to hear your response, Bala, because the editor of The Australian said the intention of the commentary in the cartoon was, in fact, to ridicule racism, not perpetuate it. Do you not find that plausible?
I think when it says that little brown girls, that was taken out of context, and it's sort of like, you know, it's reductionist, and it says it perpetuates the same message that when a person of colour, when they're successful, when they achieve something, it's not seen as based on merit. It's seen as, you know, based on tokenism.
So just to be clear, in your view, the cartoon was racist?
Yeah.
OK, Niki, Savva.
Look, that cartoon was based on something that Joe Biden had said. And he made the remark about little black girls and brown girls. And I have to say that when I heard him say that, I cringed. I think Kamala Harris is an outstanding candidate. And for so many reasons, she's smart, she's tough, she's accomplished. And, you know, she, I think, would make a brilliant vice president. But the things that we should be focusing on are those characteristics, not the other things that, you know, people keep referring to, like gender, like race, like religion, like age, all of that. So I thought that Biden had a poor choice of words there. I don't think he should have said that.
But to be fair, he should have said that he had chosen
the best candidate that he could find for the job, sure, and that was enough.
But Niki Savva, just to be clear, he wasn't describing Kamala Harris that way. He referred to young women that might be inspired to become a president or vice president because of her. Isn't it stretching reality somewhat to say that he described her that way?
The cartoon was a sledge against Biden. It was not a sledge against Kamala Harris.
I would say it was a sledge
against... That's how I saw it. When I saw that cartoon, that's how I took it, that he was having a go at Biden.
Did you take it that way, Antoinette?
I heard Biden say it, I cringed.
I don't believe... I think it was a swipe at both. I don't think the little brown girls... he wasn't using that to describe his running mate. He was using that to talk about the historic appointment and the fact that that will lead to little brown girls and little black girls going, I can do that, because you can't be what you can't see. And I know, for example, when I was growing up, and if I saw anybody diverse on television, that to me made me think, I can do that. Perhaps there's a way. Mm. And so if we're talking about context, the context was a stretch. I don't believe he was using the same words or using Biden's words. And I think it diminished Harris as a running mate. I think it reduced her. I don't think it's the most racist thing to come out of News Corp cartoons, but I think the doubling down of the editor-in-chief and sending a memo to all staff, rather than reflecting, this is where, and to your point, is this just about lack of diversity? No, but I think there's a component. Had there been more diverse people in that team, in that editorial leadership team, the conversation and reflection, I think, would have been different. I'm not saying bring down the cartoon. I'm not saying stifle satire and don't push boundaries, but I reckon there would be more reflection if it wasn't four white blokes going, hey, John, what do you think? Oh, I don't think it was racist. Peter, what do you think? And Michael and Andrew, oh, we all agree. Oh, so it's just
Barnaby?
Fine.
Yeah, look, I don't know. Look, there's a special place for cartoons. I'm sure that The Guardian has absolutely smashed Trump at times. I'm sure CNN has absolutely smashed Trump at times. I'm sure the Fairfax media you could bring out umpteen cartoons which would take certain traits of
but
a person.
But is there a place for
on the
racism?
Other side of the political field? Now, my view on the presidential race, if you haven't got a job, you should apply for President of the United States, because that job's vacant. But, you know, I'm absolutely certain if Colin Powell stood, people would go, ooh, Ray.
Michelle Wong, do you find that cartoon racist?
I do. And I think the fact that the editor needed to explain it in such a way, almost like we had to be racist in order to expose racism, I think says it all. But also, I represent a community where half of my local residents were born overseas, and the vast majority of those born overseas are from the subcontinent. And I don't need talking points or, you know, anyone else telling me what to think on this, because I've actually received feedback from my own community. When that sort of language is said in that context, it's saying that about people's sisters, their daughters, their mothers. And your point, the point to merit is correct. Like, it actually doesn't speak to the merit of someone who could very well be the 2IC to the leader of the free world.
And could be the boss.
Michelle, can I add, I've spoken to a lot of people of colour, and I've had mixed feedback as to whether they found it racist or not. But I would put to The Australian and to the editor-in-chief that when they say context is everything, well, I say context within The Australian in the context of Black Lives Matter matters, because I feel that the publication did its best to try and link the Victorian cluster to Black Lives Matter, even when the health authorities and the facts said the opposite clearly. So just a couple of weeks later, that cartoon being placed in a publication, for me, that context matters, and I think that's also why so many people took issue with it. Okay.